So welcome to today's session. This is module 3, session number 11, ergonomics for beginners, industrial design perspective. Now today the third module is that human physical dimension concern, and today's class anthropometry landmark sitting postures. Now, last session brief is that we have stressed upon the facts that body measurements include direct measurements of various body parts, say heights, length, depths, breadths, and the circumferences of head, neck, trunk, hands, and legs in some standard positions. That is the anthropometry dimensions. And when these dimensions are taken in standing in a static posture, it is called standing static anthropometry, that we have discussed in last class. Now today we will be discussing about the sitting ergonomics, it's a sitting anthropometry. Now with this sitting anthropometry, we are going to discuss how body behaves in different context, in leisure as well as in working condition, in various adopted body postures for different tasks to be performed, and specifically the sit desk type of sitting posture. What are the basic anthropometric dimensions are considered, what are their measurement landmarks, that we are going to discuss today. Now with this, if we see this figure here, it says that the structure, that seat structure, this structure or this arrangement that fits to our body. Now how we can recognize that a structure or a specific arrangement can be used as a seat? When we test it, its dimension and our body geometric dimension, the movement we can take and how we can make use of those arrangement to fit our body. So these things we need to consider, and always this type of sub judgment are going on in our mind when we see some object in our surroundings. So whether to use this type of sitting, this arrangement as a seat, it needs to be judged with our body structure understanding and the angles and movements for that. Now this type of sitting, it may be extended sitting, that is relaxing. Now whether this posture we can say that it is a seat or a bed. So it can be used as a seat as well as bed. This person can sit like this way, and then it can be a seat. So what are the difference, what are the modifications in the furniture structure that tells us how to use it? And for that the always a underlying judgment of our body structure and body dimension always going on in this judgment. Now again thing, the sitting is that the context specific sitting means here for a second, though some space is left in this side, means three persons can be accommodated in this design, in this seat, but the context and the surroundings, it suggests that if a couple sits here, then third person obviously would not choose this for sitting. So then what are the psychological allowances we require that adds to our physical body dimensions? These allowances we also need to consider, not only the seat, the person's body, breath, etc. Now, sitting variations and body behavior. This type of sitting arrangement, whatever we are seeing here in this left hand figure, the person sits here, and now you can see that if this is the seat plate and his thigh bone is like this, so here a special flesh cart is there and pressure on the thigh is there. So sitting in this posture for a longer time would not be possible, it will be tiring. And also the height of this seat and the work table does not match together, so what's happened, the person, this bending is there. So while bending and up working, so that back pain etc. will be there. So what would be the appropriate dimension for sitting that we need to consider? So for that some specific landmarks and some dimensions we need to know. So in the right hand corner also the same thing. Here what's happened, the normal chairs are used to, this type of plastic made chairs are available and it is used to, but when we are using the here the desk is a certain type, but if desk varies, then whether this match is proper or not. Now see, though this chair can be adjusted with this desk, but the preferred posture, because there is no control over our behavior, we do not know how and when we should behave, what type of things. So here, though he can use it properly, the seat, and can bring it closer to the desk, but still he sits like this, so that gives a problem in this region. So then not only the furniture dimension, but we need the furniture design should be in such a way that it should tell its users how to use it properly. Otherwise, a good design, if we cannot use it properly, it will give some bad effect, bad result. The seat desk type of sitting. Seat desk type of sitting, now the same again the problem is that like this way, these are the problems. So here it can be said that his leg cannot get proper rest here, as the total leg length and this chair, this dimension, it does not match here. So it this person requires a higher chair height to keep foot on a firm ground here. Now, so for that there are varieties of chairs are available. Now in this right hand corner, if we see that in this case the chair depth, it depends on the angle. Now if she does not use this backrest, if he goes little forward, then what's happen? Then there is a problem in this, and then there is a bend has to be there. So how to use it properly, that we need to consider while conceiving any design idea, that is the it should match with our body dimension, specifically in the sitting posture. Another thing is that we can say that now not only the static dimensions for anything, But in this figure is taken from a Sananda Bengali magazine as a health tipping. Here she says that while using this this equipment for exercise purpose, she has to lift her arm maximum to hold this handle. Now here it comes that what will be the total distance from floor to this handle would be given so that this girl can operate it easily. So now, so not only the physical body, the only the length, breadth and etcetera, the main body and trunk leg, but the upper maximum arm reach also needs to be considered. Now in this case, one thing we need to keep in our mind that here the holding point is here. Now if he has to hold, but still he can, arm can go till this level. So the arm, this total maximum upward vertical reach and the upward maximum vertical grasp is little different. So it is seen that around 7 to 10 centimeter is the lower, the lower. So this type of dimensional considerations we need to keep in our mind while designing such things. Now this our figure draws attention to consider the seating dimensions statically. Why we need a static? Because the seating arrangements and etc., what will be the height of the seats and like that is seating, and then this is the breadth of this seat, as well as dynamic requirements of a reach value also requires to be considered. Now here we will see a series of figures where it says that dynamic body dimension requirement to accommodate activities while remain seated in a position. Like in this case, now this person is sitting here and he is doing something. So it seems that he is sitting and a specific posture he has adopted here. But the same position while he is attending this dog, now see different types of things. So what's happening? The is the total space whatever he is occupying here is different than this. And another thing that when he is doing like this way, he is, has come forward, and so the total movement, the leg, the thigh this length and the knee leg, lower leg length, the static consideration whatever is been seen here as perfect, it may not be suitable here. So here for this activity he has to change his position, his some of the body parts. Then what behavior these body parts do and what type of dimensional modifications are necessary, that has to be added when we design a furniture. Means what will be the angle here, this curvature and etcetera, it to decide this, this type of dynamic movement we need to consider. Now normally sitting, if in a seat desk position, in a chair or a stool, normally it is preferable to sit like this way. But for working, this type of sitting as preferably 90 degree, all these things are ideal. But to do certain activities, this all 90 degree is not possible to have it. With all these 90 degree angles at elbow, then waist, leg, knee and this foot angle here, these are the some standard postures it is meant used for measuring some body dimensions. But due to, but when he does some activity at that time, when he moves, that movement should be considered as dynamic dimensions. Like here we can say that if the leg length is lower than the seat length, then the posture is coming like this. So, there is a muscle cut here, and also to see this, to do the activity here and to have a good vision, he has to take a bent neck. And in this case also, the chair height is short, and his short chair height, when he is taking this backrest, he all and then the distance between this front edge of the chair to this front edge of table is more, and he needs to take a backrest, then there is again the bent is there. So, for this bent, there is a problem. So, what to be considered? When the leg is height is, it does not match with the furniture leg height, then the muscle problem is here. So, now we can say that adaptation of a bent neck posture due to a faulty work surface and body supportive furniture, all these things are happening. Now, in this case, proper anthropometric dimension to be considered. Now, for this, now the problem comes that when we are using a specific seat, it may not match with many people equally, and also those fixed dimension furniture may not be adjustable to accommodate the dynamic movement supposed to perform using that design. So, for that some adjustable seat has come to market. Now, here what happens, the height adjustment is possible, seat height, seat plate, this angle movement is also possible. Now, this armrest height and then armrest front back position is possible, backrest angle is possible to maintain, different angle with it can be done, and this backrest itself, the height and angle can be modified. And to do certain activities when we need to move little bit, for that legs have some swiveling wheels. Now, in this case it is said that what type of swiveling seats we need to consider. In this case, when we use a trolley and we need a direction to movement, at that time either front wheels or rear wheel should move, and we have the swiveling quality, so that it will have a direction. But if all the four wheels are in a swiveling kind of thing, then it will move freely, but to have a direction it will have some problem. But for this seat specifically, where I need to sit and I need to move like this to do certain activities, for that purpose five legs are provided with this swiveling wheels, so that there will be free and smooth movement. So, these are the added consideration with the along with the human body dimensions. To accommodate user's body dimensions, including movement in sitting position, the adjustable seat is necessary, and the adjustable range and etcetera, it will depend on the task the user is expected to perform. So, today's class concerns those physical human body dimensions which have an impact on design dimensions in static sitting posture. And second, the structural body measurements include direct measurements of various body parts, say heights, lengths, depths, breadths, and the circumferences of head, neck, trunk, hands, and legs in some standard positions. In this case, the standard position is that sitting on a chair or on a stool position. As standard practice, the collection of body structural data, the anatomical dimensions, in static body positions is easier than the collection of body functional data in dynamic body positions. Because when a person in a static, then one can measure it. But when the person is in a movement, it will be little difficult to measure with a specific measuring devices. In that case, some indirect measurement system using videography, photography, and some others are necessary. When these dimensions are taken in sitting static posture is called sitting static anthropometry. Now, we will look into some landmarks, sitting landmarks, basically with static and then some dynamic additions to that. External human body dimensional measurements, that is the height, length, breadth, depth and circumferences taken when a man is placed in a static sitting erect posture, chest forward, chin up, look horizontal at with hip, elbow, knee and heel maintained at 90 degree angle, means a person will sit like this way with the elbow hanged downward with that 90 degree angle. So, here what happened? The 90 degree angle, the trunk will be almost vertical on the head, elbow angle 90 degree, waist angle 90 degree, hip angle 90 degree, knee angle 90 degree, and the leg and foot angle 90 degrees. And then this thigh and this arm will be in a parallel position. So, this trunk and leg will be parallel position, shank will be in parallel position, thigh and forearm will be in a parallel position. So, this is the static standard posture for anthropometric measurements in a these things are known as static sitting anthropometry. Now, we will see the landmarks. Now, whatever landmarks we are showing here, the source reference is that Chakravarti D. 1997, a book was published. The name of that book is An Indian Anthropometric Dimensions for Ergonomic Design Practice from National Institute of Design, Ahmedabad, India. Total pages 161, and the present and this present author class this person. So, this D. Chakravarti is myself here, and when we have done this work, so there are 23 different locations in India was covered. The total person we covered 961, where 710 men and 251 women we have measured, with total dimensions we measured 290 dimensions. Some of these dimensions landmarks we are providing here, and then data concern from this book, it can be directly referred. And this book looks like this. See, it is available at National Institute of Design, Ahmedabad. Now, the data normally are presented in this format, that some figure with some reference number. This reference number, that is running reference number and parameters name, and some definitions are provided there, and then data is presented following the same reference number and then parameter name, data for male, female and combined use, minimum value and percentile values of 5th, 25th, 50th, 75th and 95th percentile values provided, maximum, minimum, standard deviation and ratio, means that parameter concern and that height, body height to stature ratio is provided. Now, here we are describing this portion, that is that the figure concern and the landmarks. Now, the measurement landmarks in sitting posture, the heights. What are the definition of heights? Vertical distance from sitting surface or the floor to the respective points. If it is height, then to the maximum point of head. If it is eye, then inner point of eye, like that. While sitting in erect stretched posture, except normal relaxing sitting height, because if we stretch erect the height and if we sit in a normal posture, it reduces. Looking straight ahead with knees and ankles forming 90 degrees, upper arm kept vertical downward, making right angle at elbow, with this forearm kept forward extended horizontally. So, this is the position where the heights are normally measured. Now, heights from the sitting is that we can take the normal sitting height when a person is not stretched, but in a normal sitting posture, that is the height, normal height. So, normal height is that top of the head sitting in normal relaxed posture from the seat surface. Now, this numericals are the reference numbers we said. Now, 108 here, it says that erect sitting posture, the erect height is at top of the head sitting in erect stretched posture, top of the head from this thing. Then eye height is at inner corner of the eye height from the sitting surface. Now, where we require to, why this dimension, where we require in designing. Suppose we are making in a sitting posture, we need to make a partition curtain where many people are working, but this separator partition, it should not meet the ceiling. So, there will be an open space over, but while sitting no one should see each other for the privacy, but at that case we can take this eye height and then that barrier would cross this eye height, but when we stand we should see others. In that case what happens, the standing eye height, so the barrier height, it should be within the sitting eye height and the standing eye height, in between somewhere it will be there, so that while sitting privacy will be maintained, but while standing he can see others. In such cases this type of dimensions are necessary. So, the design applications of all these dimensions will discuss in later with some examples. At present we are discussing the landmarks for specific measurements, and it will be easier to select data from different sources, and the specific source I just mentioned right now, that we have already done earlier, and that book resource, that my book resource, still today is being used as a major Indian alternating data source. Now, the cervical is that the maximum that bony point on the neck, the cervical is the trunk height. The trunk is the most prominent spinous process of the 7 cervical vertebra. So, this is the 110, this is the height for cervical, is trunk height. Now, mid shoulder height is that with this the shoulder point, the middle point is the mid shoulder point, uppermost point on the middle level of the shoulder. Now, acromion is that where this scapula bone meets in this position. Most lateral point on the superior surface of the acromion process of the scapula, that is 112, this point, the scapula point. Then upper lumbar and lower lumbar. Now, this upper lumbar and lower lumbar, this region has a major role in seat design, specifically for the backrest design. Now, uppermost point of the first lumbar vertebra and the lower lumbar position is that lowermost point of the fifth lumbar vertebra. Now, how quickly one can recognize what is these two points? Now, simply if we see this rib cage where it matches with the this vertebral column, that point is at upper lumbar point, and at this waist bone, if we go on the pushing, tracking this waist bone where it matches with the vertebral column, that point is at the lower lumbar point. So, that portion is very important for backrest design, and that carries most of our body load and it assists in bending, etcetera. The tip of the shoulder blade, why need to know this shoulder blade is that. Now, in this case, here in this, this is the point, in this point somewhere here, this point, this is a triangle bone, this point is a shoulder blade. Lower tip of the shoulder blade, why we need to know this matter, this point? Because if there is a backrest and we are supposed to move over that, if the task demands that movement, then this backrest, it should be below that, so that it will assist in that type of movement. If it crosses that, then it restricts that movement. Now, elbow rest, lower part of the elbow. When we are sitting in the standard position, the lowest most point of the elbow, that height from the seat is the elbow rest. This will be useful for fixing the arm rest height. Waist, top of waist is that upper margin of the lateral iliac crest where the belt is worn, somewhere here in this position. This is that waist. Mid thigh, while sitting in a thigh in a horizontal position, the middle, the maximum the point, the height, this is that mid thigh height. This is required to maintain the space between the table top and the seat surface top. Now, all these heights we discussed right now, these were from above or from the seat surface. Now, some of the length heights would be from floor, like knee height. Knee height is the uppermost point on the knee at lower thigh level. This point is at knee point, this is 119, this is knee height. Now, from floor again, that thigh clearance height. So, this knee height will give an idea what would be the minimum requirement between a clearance requirement for that tabletop, so that thigh can go in when you are pushing inside. You are pushing your thigh inside the tabletop, but there is a but as per our behavior, sometimes we practice this type of posture. We raised our leg, and it is required to avoid fatigue and etcetera. So, in that case, to provide this facility, this table top should have that gap. So, in that case, this will be considered as dynamic clearances. If we consider this thigh clearance height with raised knee, thigh clearance height, the definition we can say that highest point on the knee at lower thigh, when the leg is raised forward to the maximum supported on the toes. Now, arm reaches and lengths and breadths and depths, horizontal or vertical distances between the two respective points as mentioned specifically, like popliteal. Popliteal point means for a knee, knee is at frontal and just at the rear side where thigh and this lower leg shank meets, this corner point is the popliteal point. So, that point from the floor, this height is popliteal height. Popliteal angle point at the underside of the thigh immediately behind the knee, where the tendon of biceps femoris muscle inserted into the lower leg. This biceps femoris muscle tendon, this muscles coming this side. So, in this corner point is the popliteal point. This is necessary to fix the seat height. If the seat height is more than this, then the leg will hang. If it is more than this height, then this posture will be there, and if it is less, then this type of posture will be there. So, this is very important consideration for seat height. Now, the vertical arm reach height. Now, vertical upward arm reach from mid shoulder, maximum arm reach from mid shoulder. Maximum vertical distance from the mid shoulder to the tip of the middle finger when the hand is raised upward vertically to the highest position attainable without strain. So, this dimension when we added with that mid shoulder height, then we are getting the total distance. So, for some, if we have to keep any object overhead that needs to be operated quite often, it should be within that limit. So, for that it is necessary. If it is necessary to avoid its presence for safety reason, then that location should be well beyond this height. Now, vertical upward grasp reach from mid shoulder. Now, we said that total reach value considering this maximum tip. Now, when you hold something, it is around 7 to 10 centimeter lower than this, it should be considered. So, 123 is that vertical upward grasp reaching from mid shoulder. Maximum vertical distance from the mid shoulder to the center of the hand grip when it is raised vertically upward to the highest position attainable without strain. Vertical upward arm from seat surface. Now we said that from mid shoulder, now from the seat surface, the same point, and from the floor, the distance from floor. Now length, but length means from buttock while sitting, what would be the seat length or clearances. Now 126 point, buttock to knee length normal sitting, horizontal distance from most posterior point, posterior backward, posterior point on the uncompressed buttock. Uncompressed buttock means if there is a wall, we should not press our buttock and then take measurement. So it will be free. So uncompressed buttock point, maximum point to the knee point, this distance, this length is the buttock knee length normal sitting. To the most anterior point of the knee, that is the right knee or left knee, you can consider it. This is required to have a clearance value. Suppose when we are sitting, then what is the front edge of a table? So that clearance we need to consider. But while making a seat length, it would be within the buttock popliteal length, and then if we bent, we bent our leg backward or forward, then accordingly this height will vary and the length also will vary. Now buttock to leg length normal sitting. Now while sitting, our behavior is that to move our leg like this way. So our leg movement takes this type of curved movement. Now here the normal movement, normal sitting with all the 90 degree position, foot placed firm on the floor, this is horizontal distance between the most posterior point of the uncompressed buttock and the tip of the longest toe, tip of the longest toe. So this distance, when the legs are placed on the floor with the knee at an angle at 90 degree. So this is the buttock to leg length. Now while leg is raised normally, then from this buttock point to this tip of the toe, this distance is that buttock to leg length while raised on toe. Why these things are necessary? Now when we are making a table type of structure and a modesty panel in between below the table top, and if someone sits that side, other side, and if the person concerned here, if he wishes to extend his leg, his leg should not touch others. So if we know what is the angle and what is the distance length here, then accordingly from a seat we can fix the this modesty panel. For that this type of things are necessary. And another thing is that if we need to fix a pedal where foot needs to be operated upon, then what is the distance or length we can keep there. For that all these are necessary. Then buttock leg, extended leg raised on the floor. Now when we raised photo, then how much it is coming, like that. Now, breaths. Body breaths are necessary for back rest or anything where the trunk needs to be rested for that purpose, or maybe some clearance for movement. The biacromion breath is there. The acromion point is that two bony prominences and where it emits this distance. Maximum horizontal distance across the shoulders. Breath measured between the most lateral points on the superior surfaces of the acromion processes of the scapula. This is the biacromion breath. This is this one. Now, by deltoid, these are the deltoid muscles, these thick muscles. So, maximum curve point to maximum curve point, this distance, this breadth is the by deltoid breadth. From here to here, this is the by deltoid breadth. Maximum horizontal distance across the shoulders, breadth measured to the protrusions of the deltoid muscles. These muscles are the deltoid muscles. Now, chest breath on bust, chest breath, this is that means the maximum, like here. Maximum horizontal distance across the chest at nipple level, the abdomen below, this one is the abdomen level. Maximum horizontal distance across the abdomen at its maximum extended point. Then waist, waist means maximum horizontal distance across the waist at the upper margin of the lateral iliac crest where the belt is worn. This point is at maximum waist dimension. Now, hip breath. Hip breath is the maximum distance between hip point, then thigh, middle external body single, thigh distance, so maximum thigh distance the middle, so this thigh distance, this is that thigh middle external breath single, mid thigh breath relaxed, like when we sit, normally we do not sit knees close position, we normally sit knees little apart. At that point, what would be the maximum this thigh to thigh distance? So, maximum thigh to thigh distance is like this. Then elbow to elbow distance, this was elbow to elbow closed and elbow to elbow relaxed distance. Now, knee to knee distance, the knee to knee relaxed distance, chest on bust depth and chest below bust that depth, then waist depth, then circumferences are at different points, all the different circumferences are taken, like buttock, psi means like this way, psi, but and bicep, and bicep relaxed. And then, but elbow relaxed, then knee relaxed, then calf circumference, and then ankle circumference, etc., are all considered. Now, with all these things, to have a situation like this, different body behavior accordingly, the dimensional modifications along with the basic dimensions are required to be considered. So, basic dimensions with context specific dynamic consideration makes design or task moot fit. So, with this we are concluding. Next session will be that static and dynamic anthropometry, squatting and cross-legged postures and other body parts. So, next class with this figure you can say that we will be discussing some different type of seating on floor position and the landmarks for that and the some other considerations. With this we are concluding today's session. So, next day we will meet with floor seating and that dimension and some other requirements for that purpose. Okay, thank you.